Good morning everyone. I am Aisha Bisht of class 10th and today I am here to share some information about Rani Chinnamma. Chinnamma's early life. Kittur Rani Chinnamma was born on 23rd October 1788 in Kakati, which is located in the present Belgaum district, Karnataka. She was well versed in horse riding, sword fighting and archery from a very young age. Chinnamma married Raja Mala Sarja of the Desai family, who died in the year 1824, leaving her son and the state, and soon her son also died in the year 1824. Now Rani Chinnamma was alone and she was left with the state of Kittur to be saved from the British. Now talking about the fight with British started, she adopted Shivalingappa in the year 1824 to make him heir to the throne, which irked East India Company as it was against the doctrine of lapse. And under this context, the Kittur state came under the control of the Dharwal Collectorate, where the in-charge did not accept the new ruler and asked the state to come under British control. Rani Chinnamma did not accept this and sent a letter to Lieutenant Governor of the Bombay Presidency. However, the request was turned down and what followed was the war. The first war between the British and the state of Kittur was fought heavily, where British forces lost the war when St. John Thackeray, collector and a political agent, was killed in the war. Sir Walter Elliot and Mr. Stevenson, two British officers, were also taken as hostages, who were released soon. Talking about her last days. During the second war with the British, Rani Chinnamma fought fiercely but was captured by the British forces and was imprisoned at Belhungal Fort, where she died in the year 1829 because of false news delivered by the British that Rayanna has died. Hearing this news, Chinnamma had the only hope, who is no more. She decided to die. Sangoli Rayanna, who was a loyal lieutenant of Chinnamma's army, came to see her death by changing his looks. There he decided he will fight till his last breath against the British. So he continued the war and later he was captured and hanged. We will always remember Rani Chinnamma and her unforgettable contribution.